Greetings, traveler.
Let's get started. What do you want to play?
not a big fan of Druid. I put a lot of the Jade deck to try to make the Jade work in Arena, but it looks like Druid is probably the worst one with Jade.
Yeah, honestly, I want to play more Hunter now, dude. I want to test more. I want to test more. It's not Rexxar, but we'll take it, right? It's cool.
Yeah. Let's go.
All right. So before we get too started in the draft, the concept of the last deck, obviously, at a high quality, right? High quality, no weapons, and fairly low reach, but high quality minions. So the whole strategy that I want to be doing right now with Hunter is don't focus too much on having an insane start. Don't focus too much on having an insane end game. Just have a really solid mid game. Those zip gunners work out tremendously well for a nice mid game. You get a really good spike on 4 or 5. Good 4-drops, obviously. And then just try to get by with 1s and 2s. We had like 5 1s, but only 3 2s. So I try not to have like 5 1s and 7 2s. Or say 9 2s and like 5 5 1s or whatever. I try to limit that a little bit so you don't run out of cards too fast. All right, with that in mind, what do we want here?
Ball of Spiders. It's
I like it. Yeah, good. I mean it's kind of like the Infest, right? What the other one did.
Oh man, the Infest is so good in last round.
Yeah, the Infest did a lot of work. So this is a little worse than Infest, but it comes close. So I like the ball here as well. Make sure we keep having cards in our hand.
Desert Camo is okay.
I mean, Nightblade isn't ideal for the strategy that we're gonna do. I think it's still better than a Desert Camo, right? Because the problem with Desert Camo is, CC brought that up as well, is that people are drafting Mistress of Mixtures. So not only are you pulling a 2-2 out of their deck, you're also giving them 4 health if you play Camo. So I think Camel in this meta is just not good enough because the Mistress makes it very bad. So I just picked the Nightblade here for some reason.
Sure. Makes sense.
Yeah, it's not premium. It's not premium in this style.
It's okay in Hunter, I guess.
Oh my god.
Hunter Spark?
I mean, probably, but with the Nightblade already, we get offered a Wolf Rider. I'm like, ooh, should we build a face deck?
I guess. One drop is actually not bad.
The one drop isn't terrible. I think it's definitely the Hunter's Mark or the Wolf Rider. It's not the one drop, but the one drop isn't that terrible. Like, we just saw the strategy work so well for the mid range, but we already have Nightblade. I'm just thinking there's a lot of people who aren't equipped to deal with a face deck these days, right?
But we have a Ball of Spider, which is not really a good card in a face deck.
True, but it's not unplayable. It's not unplayable because you still want something in the mid game. I think I'd pick the Wolf Rider and I'd keep the option open. I think this is definitely a pick because I have a lot of experience with these decks where it's if I would tell you like you have to get the highest possible win rate here, I'd probably pick the Hunter's Mark. But I know how incredibly fun a face deck is in Arena, so I'd pick the Wolf Rider just for the entertainment value.
Sure.
I always want to keep the option open if my first... Oh my god, we're getting reach!
Actually, Arcane Shot is probably the best pick, right?
Yeah, I think we've half-heartedly committed with the Wolf Rider, so I'd pick the Arcane Shot. I'd double down here for sure.
All right. Ooh. Not a big fan of the Secret here.
It's definitely not hidden cash. Cat Trick isn't terrible in an aggressive deck because you get a 4-2 minion, right? A 4-2 minion with stealth that does go face. Doppelgangster is sick with a Zip Gunner, but it's pretty, it's pretty meme-y, like sometimes it works, probably it doesn't. So I think I'd pick the Cat Trick here.
Sure.
Yeah, because we're trying to build a more aggressive deck. Oh my god, it's working! Yes! Reward it! Kill Command! Yeah. Booyah! Alright, we're getting there, boys, we're getting there.
God, this sucks. Duskboard is fine.
Explosive Sheep is not bad in a deck like this, and I'll explain why. Because you're running a face deck, you need to survive until you find enough reach to kill. So AoE is pretty premium in a reach deck. Now, is this premium AoE? Absolutely not. Is it still AoE? Yeah, kinda, right? It's kinda fine. So, I mean, it's not a great pack. We're not gonna get a great card here, right? So I'd probably pick the Sheep here.
Yeah, I'll for one more than I thought it's a beast, and then, oh, it's a mech. I mean, never mind.
Yep.
Oh.
Oh, yes! Let's go, Bo! Mm. Let's get some explosive traps. Oh man,
right.
yeah, I think we're all in Unleashed Hounds for me, definitely.
Yeah, Unleash for sure. Over
Unleashed goes
Mono.
first.
Yeah,
Good.
Unleash goes first.
Good card.
Oh, nice. Now we're talking.
So in this kind of deck, and once again, we're probably picking High Main, because High Main is still very solid on its own. But it's very possible that Sludge Belcher is better in this kind of deck. Because if you're one turn from killing them, they can still ignore your High Main and kill you. They can't ignore your Belcher, right? Now, that's a very specific scenario, but it does occur quite often, right? Where they just ignore your High Main and kill you. But I think you still pick the High Main, just because, you know, I mean, if you can play it on curve, the card is sick. So there's an I just want to bring that up, how Taunt is really useful in this style. Because we're drafting a very specific style, right? But yeah, we'll pick a High Main. Let's do it. Nice little High Main.
Tracking,
I
I
like the
think.
tracking. Yes, tracking gives
Yeah.
you more chance to hit your reach. So let's
Looking
do it.
forward to our reach. Yep.
Yeah, throw away the cards that don't go face, keep the cards that do go face.
Huh. One, two, two spells.
You're thinking too much, man.
Really?
Which card goes face? I'm
I
just
mean,
playing, I'm just playing. But yeah, I mean, in all seriousness, it is the Arcane Shot. It's, yeah. I've had a deck with two quick shots and three arcane shots, and that was fantastic. Like, it's super flexible.
So, never think about this one drop, maybe?
It's
Nah, I think I can
totally
do
fine, but I think reach is so rare these days that I mean, we're getting really lucky, right? We're getting all
it.
this reach. And reach just becomes it just becomes better the more you have of it. Because the more reach you have, the more you can reliably say, okay, we're gonna go face because I know I'm gonna draw lethal. So I just like to pick heaps of reach in this kind of deck.
Cool. All right. Interesting.
I like the two drop more than the alley cat.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I
No
think it's a
cat.
little. Sorry, chat. I know chat's a big fan of the alley cat.
All right. Two
Yep.
drop.
Yeah, I think it helps turn four a little bit more as well.
Mad Scientist is good. We only have one secret, but I think it's still better than Hired Gun.
If we had no secrets, I'd pick the hired gun. Because we only have
Yeah,
one
for
secret,
sure.
I'd pick the scientist, yeah. Scientist is broken if it pulls a secret. It's really
Hey,
strong.
face.
Yes! More face! Let's go, Glaive.
Right.
Oh, we're getting a good old-fashioned smorg deck, guys. I'm getting all excited. We have the sheep, that's it.
It's not quite good, but
Mechwarper works better with Glaive. Because you can buff it and then kill his 2/3. And we might get another mech. I think Mechwarper is the pick here.
Okay. Yep,
Let's do
sure.
it.
Hey, second play.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
All right.
I mean, we want AoE as well, but we'll pick Glaive. Absolutely. Glaive does early game control, Glaive does late game reach. Glaive does it all. Glaive does it all, boys. So turn three, we have Bow. It's pretty
That's
much it.
it. Wolf Rider is okay-ish.
Yeah, I mean you don't really want a Wolf Rider turn three,
Yeah,
right?
nah.
So I
I
think
think
I'd still
Grub
pick
is.
Carrion Grub. Yeah.
Yep.
I know we don't have a turn four, but we have two Glaives, and Glaivezuka is really good turn four on, for instance, a Carrion Grub. So.
Also, this land on the clay is also really good.
Yep. For sure. And if we get Shaky, Ziv Gunner, anything. Huh. So if this is any other kind of deck, you've already picked the Kraken and you've moved on, right?
Yeah, for sure. But
In a face-oriented deck, it's not always Kraken because you might think, well, shady, Kraken goes face, but it's only two damage because you can't hero power, right? So Kraken only
Yes,
adds
that's
two
it.
power, and you're paying 9 mana to deal two damage to his face. That's not that great of an investment. I'm not saying it's not the Kraken, but I think the way how the deck is going, I might rather have an On the Hunt than a Kraken here. We already have Ball of Spiders and High Main for a late game situation.
Yes.
Yeah, I think it is On the Hunt here. I think that is
Yeah,
correct.
I think one buff the spider is like good enough for late game.
Yep.
Plus a high main, yeah. Kraken is slow.
For sure, for sure.
On the hunt. Yep. Hey, charge.
Yep, charge goes face. Let's do it.
Yep. That's right. Oh, nah, charge.
First. Correct pick.
Or Huffer.
It's probably the three, yeah. We do ooh, we do have a sick amount of Hunter's Mark synergy. Like, we have two
We have
glaives,
another
we have
weapon.
On the Hunt, we have two arcane shots, we have sheep, we have bow, we have hounds, we have ball of spiders.
Yes.
And
Wow.
And there is a lot like the that Blossom Nude, right? The 3/8
Yeah.
taunt.
Also
That's
that bot
really bad
creeper,
against
right?
our deck.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think getting some insurance versus the big taunt with the Hunter's Mark is correct here.
Okay,
Yeah.
sure.
Yeah. We have a really good deck to support Hunter's Mark.
Wow. I don't think we are winning the joust, but it's a 3-2.
Well, sometimes it draws you a commander or I main. I think that's enough. I think you pick
Bob's
the
thunder.
Kellic.
You don't like the hyena?
I don't think it's bad, but in this deck, we're not going to want to trade too much anyway, so I think I'd rather have the Alec.
Okay,
Pushes one
sure.
more damage, it's better against 4/3s.
Hey, it's a trap.
Yep, I like the trap. We have the Scientist, and Bear Trap in general is pretty good in this style.
Ooh.
It's just a 2-drop for me.
Yeah, this, I think the mana room is slow.
Yeah, it's a little too slow.
Yeah,
Doesn't go
yeah.
face. Let's go face. Oh, multi-shots. Fantastic. Yes, more AoE. Yep. Love it.
Nice. Oh my God.
Let's go. More glaive. Oh man. Face Hunter in arena,
Lovely.
boys. It's probably the grandma.
We have a tracking already. Two tracking is
Yeah, I'm just thinking if we have any crazy Brewmaster synergy. We do have Nightblade, we do have Wolfrider, so for Reach there's some arguments for Brewmaster, like
a Murloc maybe? Nah. Commander.
Commander,
Yeah.
Nightblade, and Wolfrider. I think
Still.
with the triple Glaive Zuka, we just want the
Yeah,
Grandma,
it's
right? We
red
just
lines
want
and
early
the glaze look is
pressure. Yep.
disgusting. Yeah.
Yeah, but
All right,
Brewmaster is
let's go.
definitely better in this deck than on that. Oh
Oh my
my
God, stop.
god, yes! Another one!
We're picking it, right?
Yeah,
Yeah,
we're picking
similar
it.
to
My
Yuffie.
rule is you pick the first three glaives without thinking, and then on
Right.
the fourth one you compare what's in the other pack, and the other pack that wasn't good enough cards in the pack, so we moved on.
I like Zubat here.
I
It
think I like the
drops.
Zubat as well. We have Bear, Catrick, Grandma, Alec, Murloc, Croc, Grub, Ball of Spiders. Yeah, I like the
Yeah,
Zubat as well. Go for
yeah.
some more pressure.
Yeah, just the other two is kind of slow, so
Yep.
Zubat it is. Ooh.
Power shot,
Yeah,
absolutely.
Power Shark.
Yeah, AoE.
If this thing just says 4 mana 5/3 charge, I'll
Oh,
pick
pff, easy pick, easy pick. But we don't win
it.
joust with our decks right here. Oh my god, yes, I'm so. See, this is the reason, right? If you're like, especially if you're a streamer, right? Sometimes you just need to say, I know the Hunter's Mark is probably better, but we already have a Nightblade. Let's just try for the face deck. And then, you get the face deck, and they go like, yeah, baby. Feels good. It's actually a lot harder to play this style than a lot of people think. Because it's
Yeah.
Arena, you don't have a perfect face deck, right?
Every damage count.
Yep, absolutely. And if you take one trait too little, you could die too fast or lose your board too fast, and then just also lose. All right, let's do it, Ocean.
Hey, here's a Glazooka.
Right, careful with the spoilers. Just giving you a heads up from last time, right?
Right.
Like, if we draw lethal, please don't jump out of your seat. Let the chats figure it out on their own pace. But yeah, I mean, with four Glaive Zukas, you can definitely think about like, do I keep this if I don't have one? But yeah, I'd keep the Glaive Zuka. It's fine.
Do you keep
Clay,
the
thanks so much for the 70 bits.
Do you like the Patrick against the Rogue?
No, just the Glaive Zuka,
Yeah.
for sure. We
Yeah, I mean, I
have
played too
Scientist,
much
right?
destruction.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thinking. Nice.
Just doing some science. Don't spend it all at once. You actually are resubbing 4 times, Smurfstone. This is not a bug. Holy shit, thank you so much, man. I thought it was just Twitch, doing what Twitch does, right? Which is having a buggy alert from time. Constructed!
Where's the
No.
patch?
Yeah, no patches. What the fuck? So if we play River Croc, he will dagger trade. Ugh, do we need to glaive and kill this?
Yeah. I mean, the Tide Hunter, he just dagger
No,
and
it's never
3D
Tide
too.
Hunter. Tide Hunter's terrible, right? He free
Yeah, so I think
kills.
just weapon and.
Yeah, I think weapon and kill it. Yuck. Free to play, no patches. Patches in hand. I really wanted to play the crocodile. Feels bad, man.
Mind if I roll now? Okay.
Okay, that's good though. I'm totally fine playing the crocodile and killing his minion.
Yep.
Yep. Next turn we can big leave. Playing Titan Trigger wasn't terrible. But then he can go one and then dagger. Just play a fork. 3-2. Let's do it.
Ha. Huh.
Oh my god, this guy.
Weapon first and then play the 2-drop?
Yep, weapon first, play the 2-drop. I just hold the weapon and push 3-phase.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, normally you want to put that on the left, right? Now you made the trail a little better.
Yes, yes.
It's alright, it's not gonna matter. I don't think he betrayals here. It's just not good enough. But on instinct, you should put token generators on the left, so the weak guy's in the middle versus rogue. It already looks lost. Well, that's really the power of this kind of deck. It can bring it back from pretty far because of the way it's built.
Wow, I like sheep trade and then hero power. Like, trade the 1-1 into the 4.
It's definitely an option, right? The alternative is 1-phase, play Nightblade, kill the frog. He probably ends up full trading. This means we take 7 more damage, but we do get a hero power in. We don't have to use a weapon charge. If he has sap, do we just lose? Oh, you want to arcane shot your own sheep, or?
Really?
No, that was a question,
Yeah, yeah, if he's sap, I think I can arcane shot my own sheep.
So, I agree with trade 1-1 into 4-3. I agree with sheep, I agree with hero power.
Okay.
Let's get that done.
Okay.
So, arcane shot heals our face for 7 here.
Yeah.
And plays around silence. I think it's correct to arcane shot the sheep.
Okay, sure.
Yeah. Because playing a face deck, it's not about... It's not only about dealing damage. It's also about making sure you live long enough to deal damage. Be good at the game and let the toad hit the sheep. I mean, arcane shot's just strictly better then, right? Because you don't take 3-phase and this can still go phase later. Who is this funny-looking Rexxar? I know, we're not playing Rexxar. Feels bad, man. This is where you want to consider putting Argent Commander in his face.
I would go to his face. If it's a Jaime or something, nah, just Argent Commander face.
Yeah, I think Commander in his face is correct. Yeah. He probably ends up removing this, but then we go Nightblade hero power.
Are we using the weapon for his face?
I don't think so. I think we can do it next turn, right?
Sure, we can wait. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, we do have a lot of weapons left. Yeah, we should definitely start hitting next turn.
Yeah, even if we draw a weapon next turn, we still can't.
Yeah, it's if we draw 2 weapons back to back. That's what scares me. So
bad,
I think starting to hit next turn makes more sense. It definitely looks like we're losing, guys. But at the same time, there's a lot of reach in here. There's some AoE. There's a high main. He might actually take the damage here.
Nope. Yeah, so
didn't remove the shield, wow. So what do we got? 3, 5, 7, 11. We're gonna get punished for not burning that charge. He pushes 12. Oil at 6. 18. It's unlikely that we're dead, but do you wanna trade the shields? He just kills it with our face.
No. I think we trade here, we just lose.
So
maybe...
we Nightblade and we probably hero power, right?
Hero power, yeah. And then everything face.
So Nightblade hero power and face goes face. Let's do that.
Nightblade hero power. Yep. He can count to 8. Like if he can't kill us, he have to trade, right? So he's gonna do the trade for us.
Yeah, it's just that it's not super unlikely that he kills us, but I think face is fine. Yep.
Okay.
It's really not the problem for me is not that I mind that we lose this. The problem is that we might just die.
Right.
Of tankers.
Yeah. That's that for sure.
Okay. So
he's trading everything, I think.
Yeah.
Yep.
And that means we have more time. Yeah, definitely punished for not swinging him first. Holy shit. Okay, so we know he has that in his deck. That's scary. There's still a decent chance we just win here. Kill command is lethal.
Wow, I actually draw two weapon back to back.
Yup, yup, yup.
I think we played the.
We definitely played the Alec, yep.
Yeah. We can win the joust.
Hashtag got him. Thanks so much for subbing. Welcome.
So you gotta play the scientist.
And yeah, I think you do scientist hero power and then face for two and play glaive just to buff our minion, right? Or do I want to hold the glaive in case he doesn't?
I think, well, we do have another one, so.
I'm thinking about playing it just because it might land on the scientist, which means it kills his 2/3.
Okay.
On the other hand, it does give him the option that he's dead. It does give him the information that he's dead. Him not having the information that is dead might make him do a weird trade, right?
Right.
I think we hold it. Yep, I think we hold it.
Okay.
It also means if we draw a charge minion, we can get more damage in case he heals or something. Dual wield? Yeah. Wow, that's
right.
Pretty cool.
He's trading.
Hey, bear trap, go.
Bear trap.
Surprise, motherfucker! Alright, yeah, we definitely went too fast over the turn where we didn't swing with the weapon. Let's slow down, this deck is difficult to maximize.
Yeah.
GG.
Yeah, back-to-back weapon is ridiculous, but...
Would you guys be killing him this turn if you had gone face with the glaive before? No, but you would have lethal the turn afterwards, right? You would have accelerated your lethal by one turn, so, yeah. That's some pretty useful information, Smurfstone. And once again, thanks so much for all the subs. So, even though our opponent had a pretty decent opener, we're in a good position.
You see the mulligan, right?
Yeah.
I think we keep this hand.
I agree, we keep.
Yeah.
Face Hunter difficult? Yeah, I know there's the meme, and I'm not going to try and convince Twitch chat, but, I mean, there's a reason why you don't see a lot of Hunters playing this kind of style and doing well. It's because a lot of people play this deck, play it in a conventional manner, and then just lose. Or they play it... full YOLO, 100% Smorg, and then also just lose. It's actually quite difficult to optimize this kind of deck.
So he coin a 2-drop. I feel like he have another 2-drop.
Yeah, I would just glaive and kill this guy.
Yep.
In my experience, you don't coin a 3-2 if you have a 2-3. Mm-hmm. So you should have another 3-2 here. It might be Shrinkmeister, or he might just have Powered Shield and he wants to coin it.
Okay.
That's weird. Why wouldn't you lead with that? It's just better, right? So I guess we're playing Zubat and we kill the 1-1?
I think we kill the 1-1 no matter what.
Yeah.
It's just the...
I don't like Murloc Tidehunter because you get really punished by Talon Priest. Suddenly he kills your 2-1, survives, blah 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 blah. Yeah.
Yeah, also the new potion. Madness.
Face.
Whoa.
Power shot for the punish. Let's go. Multi shot for the punish. Never punish. I'm inclined to bow one guy and push three. I'm not sure whether that's smart. We could play trap and Murloc. Kill one or go face. He gets to free kill the 1-1. That's why I'm a little hesitant. What do you think?
It just, do we really want to get greedy to get the bow charge from the trap, right? If we bow first, play the trap next turn, we can wait.
I don't think we have to, but I think we can have the option. I think I would just bow down the Murloc and then push three phase.
Okay.
We can trade if we want to, so let's think about trading. We probably
prevent,
don't.
Like, any buffs. He doesn't have a buff last turn.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he had Shattered Sun, which was a buff, right? But well, I think three phase is correct, yeah.
Yeah, if you have like any kind of plus health, like, I don't know, Valence chosen, he'll buff it already.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Okay. It's not the absolute worst thing, honestly. The instinct tells me to Scientist Bear Trap and then free hit the Death Lord and pass. Okay, let's do that. Wow, this guy is going full smork on our smork deck. That's crazy. We have to be defending. I'll show them Is Giant Ocean the same person as Victor? Am I going crazy? It's definitely not Victor, no. Ocean doesn't stream. No! What if he has Potion of Madness? No! I don't think we play around that, but fucking hell, dude. That card alone terrorizes
me. I think to play this deck, we can't play around everything. We just have to take the risk and then...
But it's just such an awkward card.
Yeah.
Oh, so he's gonna Holy Nova and then hit the bear and then heal? Oh my god. It still dies to the commander, it's fine. Wow, cute! Well played.
Oh, jeez.
Well played.
I mean, it's okay. If you hero power, it's only 5 mana, 4 or 5, so... Oh, he healed the Deathlord, but...
Yeah, he'll heal the Deathlord, right, so...
So bad we get our 6 drop before the Deathlord.
Yep. Yeah, we're probably not gonna get a big minion here.
Yeah. Alright.
Hit it and go. Do it!
This is actually our next best thing, I think.
So we can full clear if we want. Yep. 3...
Full clear, get a Catrick.
So we're one damage off of keeping the bear alive as well. 3, 4. Oh no, we can double trade here. No, it's fine. So we can Argent and Bear into the Deathlord, double trades into the Bruiser, and then face into the 3/2.
Yep, I like
that. That works. Okay, let's do it. For some reason, I didn't see that. I was like, too bad you can't keep the bear alive, huh? I thought to keep the bear alive, we needed to hit somewhere else.
That's a good
kill. Yep. We're at 11 though. Holy shit, this guy went so smirk. He's like, who's the hunter now, bitch? Face. Catrick's great to play on the AoE though. That's good. And we got the high main before our thing as well. Before mind control. I'm scared to take damage because of Fellfire Potion now.
Right.
I'm not sure whether it's correct to hold the bow. But if you hold the bow now, you might also get more charges. Right. Zero mana. Freeze
Zero
potion.
Mana.
Freeze potion. Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's giving away. He's got a freeze potion. No Fellfire.
Alright, so Jaime is just gonna freeze it, right?
Yeah, Jaime will get frozen. We might even be better off doing like Nightblade Hero Power or something.
Or Nightblade 2 drop.
That makes AoE really good though.
Yes, and we do. He doesn't AoE last turn, right? Or he can always top deck or whatever.
Yeah. So the 4/2 always goes face. Nightblade always gets played. 1/1 always go face. That always happens.
You don't like the 3/2 hero power? I guess. Yeah.
No, I like the 4. I want to bait the freeze with the Nightblade.
Sure. Alright, I like squeeze. 2 drop, EP, AoEs.
I like hero power and just trade off the bear. I think that's fine.
Okay.
It's a little slow, but I think that's fine.
I think trading is definitely right. It's just the question of hero power or 2 drop.
Yeah. It's not about risking the high main, guys. It's like we know he's got the freeze, so I don't want to miss out on a hero power here. We'll play it next turn.
Oh my god, for real?
Just drafted Kazakus. So, you know that better than me. How much reach does he have with that?
If he's picking 5, he should have deal 5 damage. Picking 10 is deal 8 damage, right?
Okay. So we should probably stay above 8.
Then oh my god, I forgot to track. He clicked the first one to show which one it is. I didn't saw that one.
Oh, it shows you which one he picked, or what?
Yeah, it shows you which one to click, because like the card gets like a buff or whatever.
Okay, I'm gonna have a look at the replay. I think he took 10.
Yeah, I mean, logically, he should take 10, right?
Oh, he went to the first one for a second. Am I not seeing this correct?
That's a freeze.
Nice, baited the freeze.
And we get the cat.
And we get the charge.
Nice. That's a KC.
How much is this? Holy shit. 5, 8, 10... Lethal? No, 2 off.
2 off.
5, 8, 10, 18, 19. It's pretty good. So, he probably can't kill us if we take 2 damage here, right?
I don't think he can. I'm just afraid of the polymorph one. So like high main is terrible against that.
But don't we just like how much can he polymorph for five? How many targets does he polymorph?
Is that like 2 random or 3 random? I forgot. Like 10 is everything polymorph, but he's 8 mana.
All right. So let's play high main hero power. I think that's fine.
Yeah.
And then I think commander into Kazakus, face into socialites, and face with the others is fine.
Wait, what? Face into the...
Yeah, face into socialites, and then face for 5. I think that's fine.
All right, I just don't know what that 2 mana card called, so...
Oh, socialite, yeah. So it's 5 mana, only polymorph 1. If he spends his 5 mana on polymorphing 1, that's okay, right?
It's a random run, right?
Holy okay. Sure. Still a shit ton of damage. 10, 18, 20, 22, 23.
Yeah, that's probably Lisa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scared of priest having reach. What kind of world are we living in? I know, dude. I know. All right. I'm going to go get another drink. If he just heals face, you can just kill him and you can queue up. I'll be back in time.
Okay, sure.
All right, be right back, chat.
This damage is crazy. Well played.
Alright, I'm thinking croc and bow.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Alright, let's do it. Nice, that felt good because he did some crazy shit. It's like, priest, stop, please.
Yeah.
It's just always scary. If you're playing a pure phase deck, priests are super scary. I guess that's one reason to not draft it. Phase decks are really awkward if you have a priest.
It's gonna buff the beast, right? Yeah, nice.
Yep, it could happen.
Oh. That's,
Awkward.
Croc first? Because Grandma just died and he have a weapon. Grandma next turn is probably better.
Well, if you Grandma now... He trades off
hero power,
and then next turn, if you crocodile now, he kills it. Next turn, you grandma. If you grandma next turn, the 2-drop, he doesn't have a 2-drop because he hero powered. Huh?
Like I just think there's higher possibility to land the Zubat if we play the grandma next turn.
I don't think so, right? Because if you grandma now, he daggers to do the 1-2 kills the thing. And then you crocodile, and then you get to Zubat a crocodile. That's just better, right?
Okay.
I'd coin a grandma. Yeah.
Okay. He might mess it up. Treat first, hero power. Ah, that's wrong.
It's probably just hero power, kill it, and then crocodile. I think it's fine. Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
Easy there, big boy.
Does that tell us anything?
I think weapons? He basically says, you need to trade because I'll go kill your guy for free. But he doesn't know we're playing a face deck, so...
Yeah.
I think now we might just double down and play Alec and go face.
Wow.
Oh, no. For some reason, I thought he can't kill both. Of course he can kill both. What am I doing? Yeah, crocodile and hit him in the face. That's much better. Yeah. For some reason, I'm like, yeah, we just play Alec and he can't kill both. Like, oh, right, he's got a minion. He can trade the minion. Yeah, that seems like a thing. All right. Face it, be my guest. Don't worry, guys. Professional arena player at work right here. I got this. Shady, why not keep Wolf Rider? Good question. It might seem like you want to keep reach cards if you're playing a fast deck, right? Like, why not keep the cards that go phase if you're going to play a phase deck anyway? The answer is that you want cards that do something in the early game and don't do that much in the late game, as opposed to cards that work really well regardless, right? Whereas a Wolf Rider is always going to deal three, a Crocodile isn't always going to do work later. So you want to get those early curve minions out first, and then your reach cards later in the game.
All right, so weapon looks okay, and trade.
That's my first instinct. I'm like, what if we Zubat and
I just feel like
free kill? So then the dragon kills the Zubat, you're left with a 3-2. If you bow the 3-2, you're left with a 2-1. I think it's better to Zubat, actually. And then free kill the Buccaneer. Or you're thinking he needs to weapon if you do this, and he needs to have another 2-drop. No. Good catch. Let's use the bow. You're right. Bow the fairy and kill the Buccaneer. I'm assuming that he wants to weapon, right?
Yeah.
That's not a good assumption.
If you weapon down, kill this, he only can play a 2.
Yeah, it's not only that. It's you're not even sure he's got another 2, right? Because he played Fairy Dragon on turn 3. Okay, I guess he just top deck one. So now the Zubat will be better, but meh, it's fine. It doesn't matter.
So I guess now we play the 2-2.
We probably do, yeah.
Play this card first.
Elec for sure. You might even Hero Power instead of Catrick. I don't think you do, but I'll just throw it out there. Because technically you are missing 2 phase damage. But I think the Catrick, first of all, it messes with his mind. Second of all, it might increase the bow charge, etc., etc. So yeah. I'd use Catrick here. Think too much, simply smork. Yeah. Professional is a broad term. Those guys on the show Jackass are professionals as well. Okay, Frothy. Made me feel a whole lot better now.
Right.
Professionals. Yes. Oh, he's playing a Jade deck.
Wow. He's trading? Alright.
Yes, take more face. I don't think I want to Nightblade yet. I think I want to squeeze in a Hero Power and play
Zubat.
Yeah,
just Hero Power Zubat.
Yeah, do we kill something or do we hold a weapon?
Hold, I think.
Let's Zubat Hero Power. Last time we held a weapon and we were sorry, right? So let's assume.
We got Forkly Zuka, but
I think we're fine holding for another turn. Yep.
Yeah. Cool.
I really like the shady smirk emote. When I use it on other chats, it really freaks people out. Yeah. He turned out a little creepier than we intended, but I like it. I like it.
Just play a spell.
Spells in arena, dance game.
This is what happened like when I play Constructed Hunter. It's like you just play a bunch of spell, I mean the trap, and just never get triggered.
Yeah.
People play around it stuff. Testing the freezing.
Oh my god.
That's a spell. That's actually
yeah,
a JTAC.
Yeah, sure, I can probably. Yeah. Oh my god. He just actually drafted a JTAC. This is insane.
Yeah.
So what do we got?
Good.
5,
got a lot of damage.
7. 14. Yeah, we could probably just kill him.
Kill command phase hero power.
So how likely is he to kill us? Not very,
7
right?
Plus 6,
10, 13. He needs 1 damage plus eviscerate. That's not super likely. Alright, yeah. Kill command phase, hero power phase, all phase. You can't fight for the board ever here, so.
Yeah, no way we're doing the board.
It's gotta go.
It's face time!
Face time, boys! What we say is the best warrior arena archetype at the moment. I've had a 12-0 with a Tempo Warrior. It was a disgustingly good deck, but I think Tempo Warrior is still the way to go. I hope he's trying to scare us. We're dead to Shuriken and Abyss if he's got that.
I think
that.
He's like, I don't want to come, just play all everything.
He's just showing it.
Smork. Smork beats Jade. That's
there's a lot of people that are gonna struggle with that deck. Holy shit, dude. Yeah. That's a lot of Jade cards.
I'm not queuing to opponent right now. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, I think it's just taking a while.
So, I need to find a Smork opponent for this
one.
Oh.
Okay. Why must it be the cheater Anduin?
Dodge everything?
Throw it all, yep. Throw it all.
Turn one, Arcane Shot Face.
Didn't you get 12-0 with Fool's Bane control with one shield block? That might have also happened, but that's not in this meta, right? I meant 12-0 in this meta, Badger.
That's the one we did, right?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. We had a pretty good warrior.
It's before the new expansion. Yeah.
Yeah, Priest very scary for this kind of deck. Bear Trap's probably pretty good here. Mm-hmm. I always like to mind game my opponent a little bit with Bear Trap, right? So, no, don't play it yet. Yeah, just you want to, essentially what you want to convey is you're not happy playing this trap. It's like, do I really have to freeze this Argent Squire? I guess I freeze this Argent Squire. Mm. Let's put it down.
Wow, next level play.
Savage Brute, thanks so much for subbing. Dude, welcome. Because you're... Like, if you slam the trap, your opponent's like, what trap could you possibly be happy about playing into my 1-1? That's gotta be a bear trap, right? And then you might not hit. So, I think this works out. Welcome to the
Wow.
Zeitgeister, thank you for that compliment. Unfortunately, I've already had the RSI issues for more than 2 years, so it's probably not going to get better. But thank you for the kind words.
Look at this all Hunter card hand. Nice. I think so, it's still the grub.
Valence is a little scary. Do you want to hedge a little bit and kill something?
We do have a Hunter Smart.
I know, that's why I'm saying. So grub, I agree with. Grub is getting played.
Okay.
So if our opponent plays Valence on the shield next turn, we can Hunter's Mark. Kill it. That's not a big deal. The only question I have is, do you want to hedge and kill the 1-2? Or just push 3 face and say, I'll deal with the 1-2 when it's time to deal with the 1-2?
I think with this hand, I got Unleashed Hound, I got Power Shock. I think I'm going face.
Potion of Madness is not that good here either. Yeah, I think face is fine. That's correct. We are still a face deck. Yes, it's a priest. Yes, he's going to heal. But we have... We've got the options here. Ooh, nice.
Sure.
That's fine for us. So, it's probably Power Shot. It's just, do we Hunter's Mark Power Shot? To keep the 2-5 healthy?
Hunter's Mark is... do we want to waste on a 4-4?
It's not a waste because of that.
It's not a waste, yeah.
It's a hedge against Potion of Madness, because if you Power Shot and trade, he can steal your grub and ram it into the bear, and then you're kind of just lose.
Okay, I'm okay with Hunter's Mark and
Power Shot. So let's mark the Ogre, and then Power Shot in the middle, 2-5 into the 1-1, 3 phase. Icing your forearms? Oh, I mean, like I said, I even do cryotherapy, Zeitgeister, which is basically freezing my entire body. Yeah, I ice, obviously, and ice is pain relief, right? But pain relief isn't really what we're after. We're after something that is a little bit more long-term.
I'm not trading the Shredder.
No. It's just this Glaivzooka, right?
Yeah, do we play the Glaivzooka first and then Scientist, I think.
Well, you could Hero Power instead, that's the thing.
Yes.
If you Glaive Scientist and go all phase, how much is that? 3, 6, 8. 8 damage, he gets to 16. He kills the bear. We've got 2, 4, 6. 10 damage. I'm getting close. Yeah, I think we... Do we Scientist first? No, that's really bad. No,
Yeah, we
Glaive
miss one
first and
damage.
then Scientist. It's not wasting a damage, it's the
Yeah.
like
Everything
I didn't
glaives,
want to
right?
land it on the bear. Face with the minions for sure. I don't think we go face with face yet, right?
So we just hold?
Yeah, I think we hold. Yeah.
Alright.
I wanted the hero power to not miss two damage, but I think we want the commander next turn and have the option to use our weapon. That's why I want to do that.
Interesting.
Dragonfire? No, sure. So our secret is cat trick, 100%.
Yes.
So if we face the 4-2 and then charge him for 6, he's down to 12. We have a
Can
4-2
pull
Divine
him, right?
Shield. He can Potion of Madness the Scientist, that's really bad.
Whom to shoot?
He haven't done that last. Last turn's bad. Yeah, he can do that.
Last turn it's not that great, the potion, I think, right?
I don't think. Okay, I don't think we're trading here because we have an Unleash. I just Argent Commander, everything face in case we top deck a weapon.
Well, the wow, you wouldn't even kill the
Yeah.
4-2? 6-8, he goes to 10. We're probably not getting there. So 10, Potion of Madness, bump, bump. Potion's pretty bad regardless.
Yeah, potion is bad no matter what.
I think you
I
just
can't kill the four two easy.
trade into the 4-2 with your minion and then just face with the charge. I think you just kill off your scientist.
Okay, kill off the science.
Yeah.
We clay face with the
No,
weapon,
no, no.
right?
Hold, hold, hold.
No,
One
hold.
more
Okay.
turn. Yeah.
Okay, sure.
We're not there yet, right? We're not there yet. It's a priest as well.
Sure. Wow. Okay.
It's a good start. Sweet.
That's a high main.
6, 8, 10, 12. Oh, did I fuck it up again? I assumed the 4-2 was getting dealt with. I guess face would have been fine. 6, 8, 10, 12. Yeah.
Yeah, if
I
I go
missed.
face
I
with.
missed lethal again. Sorry, dude. That's really my
It's okay, it's
bad.
okay, it's okay, it's okay. I think it's
Looks like I'm
still.
terrible at judging this.
Yeah, just high main go face. We're going face with the weapon this turn. Like,
Absolutely. The weapon definitely
yeah.
goes face. The minion
I
definitely
think
goes
the
face.
minion definitely goes
I
face.
don't. I'm not sure what it would be high main, honestly. Like, you could
Really?
hero power hounds and just push
I'm just
face
thinking.
here.
Thinking if he deal with high main with like entomb or whatever, he spent his whole turn, and
Sure. He can't death and Holy Nova as well.
yeah,
Yeah, it's alright to play the high main here. Let's do it.
yeah. Like, there's no way to deal with our board and
Yep.
somehow get
No,
a
no, no, you're
hero.
right, you're right, you're right, you're right.
Yeah, I guess
I
that's
still think it would be correct to trade off the scientist, which we did.
Yeah, that's the red.
Yeah,
Plus we
but
get
not
the.
hitting face with weapon is definitely wrong. Yep.
Yeah, this is a
Catch.
hard deck to play.
This
Like,
hat is messing up my hair. No, I mean, I just didn't take long enough there. It's to be able to learn as a player, you just gotta admit when you made a mistake, right? I just didn't take enough time there. It's not that it's necessarily harder than another Smaug deck I've played. It's just
is someone
I gotta
injured?
account for the extra weapons. I just gotta. Just gotta do it,
Yep, I think that's the game. Like, he
right?
can't. Why will when you trade first? Yep, that's the game.
You have been.
Cool.
Of course, I'm also like out tabbing and like dealing with chat and stuff, but that's no excuse. It's definitely a misplay not to hit face there. Not healing phase, what? Yeah, I guess he was trying to draw something. Maybe he had the potion that healed for 12 or so, I don't know. To be fair, Shady, a good arena player would never hit phase there. It's not about playing against a good arena player, because you know what constitutes as a good arena player in most people's mind is very rare. To come back to the bear trap comment. You can assume that people will hit face there if you sell it a little bit.
All right, do you keep high main against a paladin?
I'm definitely considering it.
Because like the best way he deal with it is like pull it down to one attack.
I don't think so, because I think the deck is pretty good, and I think we'd actually lose if we keep Hymen and we hit Ball of Spiders. I think it's probably a full mulligan here.
Yeah, also, we're getting the coin for the first time, so we can, like, coin a 2-drop into Glazuka. That would be the dream.
Yep. Also, like, Sheep was also a consideration, but... There we go! There we go, boys! The Hunter starter pack. There we go.
Sure.
Stop! Why do people have... Okay, that's fine. I was about to say, like, why do people keep having things? Coin Crocodile?
Arcane Shot? Nah, Crocodile.
Yeah, Crocodile. I like the upside.
Yeah, that's also like, I'm not a big fan of that card, is why like I play it and opponent like play a 2-3 and then suddenly I'm behind.
Well, I mean, it's the difference between you having an empty board or you having a 2-2, right? So,
right,
it's definitely better than passing turn one, but yeah. Mm-hmm. Alright, now play a 2-3, then we wreck him. That's fine. That's even better.
Alright, that's good.
So make sure you take damage before killing the mixtures. Mm-hmm. Okay, there we go. I mean, you can even use face on the mixtures, it's fine. Just as long as you didn't use Crocodile on the mixtures before killing the micro. That's the only possible misplay.
Gotcha.
Good. Scientist Arcane Shot's not too bad here.
I like it.
Alright, let's do it. You could Bear Trap, but I think Scientist makes more sense, right?
Yeah. Just turn 4 is kind of awkward, since we have a bow and a secret.
Turn 4 will just be bow.
Sure.
We'll use bow and scientist to kill us turn 4, or we'll go phase.
Yep. Either way. I'll show them all.
Decks with things in them? Oh my god. Overpowered. Actually have cards.
Oh wow, that's a good turn 4.
Yeah, I'll take it.
And that's a pretty good card.
Yep, play the Zubat, free kill with the Scientist, push 4 face. Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Yep, now I kind of agree. Does Hymen keep is a mistake?
I mean, you can draw really well and it's technically not a mistake, right? But.
Well,
don't draw the cat trick now. Okay, we're good.
Are we good? Bow into the taunt and the scientist and play the bear trap?
Bear trap might be a waste. Let's use scientist and bow into his guy. That's always happening. Now let's talk about whether we kill this 1-1, and if we do, with what minion we do kill the 1-1.
If we kill, we waste the Croctile, right? Play around Consecration. But we do have a cat. We'll still play.
So if we don't kill it, we'd hero power and we'd push 7. That's too early, I think. Mm-hmm. I think I use the 4-2 and hero power and then push 3. The reason for hero power over Bear Trap is that he's probably not hitting our face right now.
Yes.
And now you could actually just lose 2 damage in the long run.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Do you follow your win rate with and without coin? It could be. Like, I'd have to check the bot.
So what's the secret again? Oh, cat trick. Okay.
So if you on the hunt, hero power grub, full smork, Nightblade hero power is lethal, I think.
Wow, that was quick.
Let's have a look. We have 7, 10, 12, 13. 16, 18. Yes.
Yeah.
So on the hunt phase, play the grub, hero power, full smork, including the weapon to play around taunt. Shady, I have to pause you. Play in league. Have a good one, Shadowbreaker.
Alright. Well, that's actually really important. The last turn we hero power, then we wouldn't have Lee Sedol.
Yeah, it's those little things you pick up playing this kind of deck a lot. Oh, I mean, that means he's not dealing with our board that well, so
yep.
It's probably still fine. But yeah, brutal. I was actually thinking about playing around that, but This is
no,
fine.
We don't play around that card if we're going face, right? Yeah.
Five, eight. Still pretty hard for him to deal with everything. Boop, boop, boop.
He still can clear the board, but if he somehow play a spell, right?
So hero power always happens no matter what we do.
Yeah. Yep.
We need the damage. If we push the three, he's at eight. Push another three, he's at five. I think it's just Nightblade full smork. Let him trade.
All right. So
well, let's Nightblade for sure, right? Because we could potentially trade the 1/1 to make it more awkward for him, but. I don't think it does enough. I think you still just full smirk.
Yep.
You have the bear trap to
block for another turn.
Yeah, exactly. There's no spare part, right? So there's no.
Nope.
There's no. Yeah. It's going.
Whoa! He tested that already, right? He tested that last turn.
I guess he might have AoE if that's what he's doing. I protect.
Okay, that's sure. That's a cheat. Oh, we can get kill command.
Yeah, tracking. Burn through some, get some damage.
Yep. Hey, that's
G. That's why tracking's good in this style, guys. You just wanna dig through your deck, discard everything that doesn't go phase. Discard cards that don't go phase. Continue going phase after that. Bear trap might scare him if he considers explosive. True, but the value of a potential mind game does not outweigh a hero power at this stage. Like, potentially gaining something with a mind game, but losing a hero power is just never worth it. Aleria versus Uther. Oh my god, more paladins! No!
Oh, hello there.
Yeah, well, hello there, mad scientist. How are you doing today?
Would you ever keep a sheep? That's too slow. No, that's just wrong.
The only thing I'd consider is Arcane Shot, but I'd probably keep just Scientist. That should offer a glaive.
Sure. We have four glaives, so.
Even Igorombo is pretty good with Scientist. Just want to dodge the secrets. Alright, I mean, not a fantastic opener, but On the Hunt is decent in the early game.
There we go.
Yeah, there we go. Mad Scientist, let's do it, man. Pew pew!
So you'd be a mini bot, which probably gonna happen since it's 5-0 paladin.
Probably on the hunt. Let's think about it. What would you say are the top arena classes at the moment? Warlock. So good, man.
Ooh.
Yeah, ooh. It's probably not to play, but let's consider it. So on the hunt, Arcane Shot clears the board. We have 3 damage on the board, we push 2. Alternatively, we glaive and trade. We have 2 power in the form of the weapon. He plays a thing. We can then kill it with our face and a spell, potentially get a hero power in. That means we don't have the repeated damage from the minion going in next turn.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. I like On the Hunt plus Arcane Shot.
And then next turn we trade the 1-1, then we glaive, take out a 4-3. Or we glaive first if it's a 3-4.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay. Yep. On the hunt, Arcane Shot. Push 2. Yeah, the minion staying alive and going face is what makes it worth.
Yeah, it's just. It could be argued like we could draw secret, but we got 2, so.
Yeah. I think that's always the scary thing, right? You didn't realize there were 4 glaives? Oh, yeah. This is a full schmork. Non-hunter players, from what I've heard, tend to underestimate the power of tracking. Yeah, for sure. People look at it as in, I'm destroying my cards. That's a bad card. But, I mean, those are just cards you have to imagine were going to be at the bottom of your deck anyway. Like, unless you actually hit fatigue, it's irrelevant. And you don't hit fatigue with hunter very often, so. So it's very tempting to get the Wolf Rider going.
Yep.
But that does make Consecration a thing.
Well, if we Glazuka and use the weapon to kill, consecration is still a thing.
Yeah, but then you can Wolf Rider mini
yeah.
phase.
Yeah.
So if we Wolf Rider now, trade a 1/1, 2 phase, consecrate is bad. Anything else, it's probably better. Yeah, I think trade the 1/1, Wolf Rider mini phase.
Okay.
Yep. If it's consecrate, it sucks, right? But I don't think.
Oh, yeah, consecration is a good card, so.
Yeah, it's I mean,
this
you can still draw a 2-drop, right? If you hit a 2-drop here, you can 2-drop Glaive. It's not a
right.
not completely out of the question.
Mount up. Okay.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
All right, I'm leaning towards trading the scientists. Equip Glaive, kill it with phase, push for phase, develop Croc.
Yep, that's the best play.
All right, let's do it. There were a couple alternatives, like you could try and land the damage on the Croc, try to land it on the Wolf Rider to trade that, but I think this is correct.
Is there a reason to hero power instead of? No, it's too early. So he doesn't have a consecration, we know that.
Or he was too greedy on it. Regards from a lurker friend of mine who had a 12 win hunter today. Awesome, dude. Hunters are back. Hunters are back.
Okie dokie. Huh. Unleash kill command next turn looks really sweet.
Yeah, he's not killing off too many of his own guys. Definitely hero power this turn. Definitely face
yep.
with a 4-1. The rest is debatable. So would you throw the weapon face, or would you kill one of his guys? Or would you hold?
No, I'm not killing his guy because I got Unleash. Like, I may be wrong, but...
The thing is, he will probably double trade into one of your guys, right?
Okay... Yeah.
You could also Unleash here and go face.
Then if we don't have a beast, then we might be sad with our kill command, right?
It's not very likely he kills all beasts, but
okay.
All right. Let's play Mech Warper, put the crocodile in his face. I think face with face is fine. Yep.
Wait, face with face?
Yep.
Huh, okay.
Like, he probably ends up removing the Warper, but you might draw another
right.
weapon. You could kill a 2-2, but then if he starts buffing stuff, then you miss the damage. I think this is fine.
Okay, sure.
I'm Warlock's the best arena class, mini-me. Sorry, what were you starting to say, Ocean?
No, I was just saying maybe we're gonna play Unleash plus kill command, so probably holding the weapon, but nah.
I think hero power unleashed last turn was the best play if you're playing for pure damage efficiency. But I think if you're willing to play a little bit around the downside of a potential AoE, holding the Unleash is okay. None may steal our sure.
That's game, right? Yep.
Yeah. This alone is 9 damage.
Oh, got a beer.
Oh,
crab,
surprise, dude. Motherfucker! now you just kill right. command his face and
yep.
make him think that he killed himself. Well played.
You play around this trap for the entire game and then you go face. Sorry.
Well, I guess at this point he's like, well, I mean, it has to be like a death trap right now for me to be able to do anything, so. Mm.
Okay, 6-0, let's do it. Oh.
How do you feel with what class is the best chance to draft a crab deck and a good one? Probably Paladin. Paladin's really polarizing. Keep the Glaive?
Yep.
Dude, is that the third priest? The fuck? Motherfucking priests? Okay. Mm. The enemies need healing versus Warlock, actually. Yeah, either that or an aggressive start. How do you think classes stack up in overall potential for Arena? I think that's a little bit too long to answer, Slendy, when we're also playing. The short answer to that is Cabal number one, and then Paladin Rogue close there. I'm really not sure where I have to place Hunter right now, so I'm going to be playing lots of Hunter to find out. We have to believe that.
Yep.
Warlock is the best class in Arena, but if he has no weapons, then he destroys himself with hero power. Once again, it's just not true. How does a Warlock do against a mage with good removal? I mean, if you have a good curve, then it's kind of hard to remove, right?
Zubat, yeah. Pray for no Valen.
Zubat pass. We never killed a creeper, right?
Nah.
Let's think about it. If we kill it, then 1-1, 3-1, 3-5. We can kill it back with our face if he's got a Valence.
Yeah, if he have a villain, it's the right thing to kill it. If he doesn't have a villain, it's the wrong thing.
Yeah.
I think it's a 6-0 priest with a coin 2-drop into a 2-drop.
Priest is also pretty likely. Mm-hmm. Shady, stop. There's enough Warlocks already. Yeah, I mean, you don't have to play Warlock if you don't want to, but it's pretty strong. I think you hold it.
Sure.
MechWarper first to get the value next turn. It's not a terrible argument. Okay. Pretty happy we didn't pop it then.
Mm-hmm.
Shady, can you experiment with Rogue after you get a good feel on Enter? It's on my list. I've got a couple of things that I'm working on. I'm not prioritizing anything over the other right now. I mean, it's really two things, right? It's either kill the abusive, play Warper, play another Glaive.
Yep.
Or 3-3 versus these things, or yeah, Power Shot. If we Power Shot, he plays a 4. I think that's kind of bad. I think you just kill the 1-1 and then MechWarper get another glaive out.
Okay.
I think you want to Power Shot and use Face to kill something next turn, or Hounds and yep. use Face to kill something next turn.
Right.
This is obviously weak to another buff like Dark Iron, but no, this is pretty much what we were trying to do.
Oh, he's actually playing around. No, he didn't. 2-drop, go. You see, he's thinking about attacking. No.
Like, we don't really want to trade, but. You could unleash, kill it that way. Ooh, that makes things.
That's really
very good.
That's
very good. Yep.
Yeah. Safety 3-3.
Yep. Then power shot, face for 3. Pew pew.
Trading a face stack, what is this?
Yeah, you do most of your trading against priests, because if they get the board, then it doesn't matter how many face cards you have, you're still not going to win.
Mm-hmm.
If you give them the board early on, then they're just going to laugh at your face and like, la 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 la, let me just heal. Oh my god. Oh, he got the synergy in Arena. So nasty. So that's probably a Glaivezuka. If we're being honest. Commander and face to kill it. Face with our guys.
Yep.
Once again, it's a lot of trading, but it's priest, so. Priest stone. Yeah, priest is the hard counter to this deck. So a little bit unfortunate with the matchup so far.
Yeah, interesting.
Yep, that's fine. Heal face? Yeah, actually got the glaive.
Kill the 4-2, I suppose.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So this is the point where we may have to start ignoring.
I think so. Nightblade is hero power.
So that's 5, 8, 9, opponents at 10. Yep, Nightblade hero power. Full schmork.
We do have 4-4 against a priest.
Yep. So. He can remove it, but it would mean he takes damage. I guess the worst card for us is here is like an AoE, where he doesn't have to take any damage. No.
Or this.
Yep.
Well, we do have a Hunter's Mark, so.
Yeah, and looks like the way he's trading, we might get through. Is he taking the 4 here to protect his taunt?
I wouldn't. Why he's going face? That's weird.
Yeah, I probably would have saved it. Pretty low. Ooh. How much is that? 6, 8. We
One damage
are
off?
close to killing him. Yeah,
Oh
3
no,
damage
it's
off.
3 damage off. 3 damage off, yeah.
Three hounds. Huh. 3 plus 1 here. 4. So 4. Yeah, I guess we just hounds and then glaive, right?
Yeah.
Or do we need to glaive?
Yeah, I mean.
Yeah, we kind of need to
Oh.
glaive. We need the power on one of our dudes. Yep.
Well, I mean, glaive is same as hero power, right? Deal 2 damage. So
Yep,
just
that's true.
trade.
Yeah, trade the 5 and the dogs.
Do we play the 3 drop? Or do we face?
I think
I
we
think we.
hero power and then go 3 face into the 1/2.
Oh,
To
face into the
prevent
1/2.
trades, yeah.
Okay. Yep.
This means you threaten lethal, right?
Yep.
Whereas if you play the grub, he can hit the grub, potion of madness the grub, trade the grub, and then you probably lose.
We still have a lot of damage. Still have a kill command, Wolf Rider. Two arcing shots, I think.
Good execution there. That was fast. Good stuff. Take 6 or no balls. Definitely not taking a 6 there, guys. Oh, we just win.
Huh, why not doing this first? He's actually building a dragon priest.
Yep. Oh, he might have. Oh, look at
Why
that. Yeah,
not?
he actually has Dragon Priest. Holy shit.
Yeah. I'm
GG,
saying he has a
boys.
dragon. Yep. GG.
Whew.
Look at this sheep and mech warper's energy.
That was a clutch turn. There were a lot of decisions there. I
Yeah,
think,
the clutch is the
yeah.
kill the 1/2.
Yeah, kill the 1/2, don't play the grub. I think that's definitely the winning line there.
Yeah. All right, it's 7-0. I'm gonna use the restroom very quick.
Go for it, man.
All right.
Attempting 120 in 10 with Hunter.
You're tracking on one. Oh, we don't have any one
No,
drop, so.
I would throw it and try to land a weapon.
Okay.
I like tracking more later on when you're looking for. Oh, we do have a one drop. Look at that. We might actually play it.
Really?
Well, if you do and he plays a 3/2, you can glaive and kill it. If he plays a 2/3, you can also glaive and kill it. This may have changed things.
I
Yeah,
see.
now
I
you
like
pass, so
skipping on turn 3.
you want to do it on turn 3 now. Yeah, I
Yeah.
agree.
Yeah, we're 7 wings, 7-0.
Shady, but Paladin can buff minions before. Yeah, that's my whole point, right? That's why I was talking pre-MSG.
All right. Ooh, still scientists.
No, it's definitely
Same.
not super straightforward here. So Grandma's definitely better versus the axe.
I think that's good enough.
I agree. Yep, sleep with the grandma.
That's like the secret we're gonna get is a cat trick, which probably not gonna trigger.
Well, he has coin, so
Oh yeah, coin, yeah.
it's it might be very likely it's going to trigger, but see what he does. But I don't like playing into the War Axe
Yeah,
on
I think
curve.
our hand is also better with the grandma. We have the on the hunt plus Clayzuka.
There's a lot of flexible damage, that is true. You don't keep tracking for the same reason you don't keep reach. Yeah, pretty much. You want it in the mid to late game to thin your deck, look for reach. I didn't mean buffing before MSG, I mean before they are played. Yeah, you're not understanding me, no King Random. I was talking about how Paladin pre-MSG was just all about do they kill my things so they can, can I buff it? And then you're talking about something else, right?
We're playing the scientist.
Yep, scientist face for one is fine.
still save the tracking later, right?
No, actually, for some reason, I completely spaced out and didn't see the tracking.
It's just if tracking could get like high main, which is like the card we want against.
Yeah,
player.
I think you track here. No, now you're absolutely right. Yeah, I need to interact less with chat and focus on the game here. Holy shit.
Okay.
So let's just see what we do next turn. This turn it's scientist, which means that we'll have 2 and a 1 on the board. He plays a thing.
We're on the rope.
Yep, I can see.
Alright.
I think I like ball of spiders.
Okay.
Yep.
Sure.
And then play the scientist. Place for one. The reason why I like ball of spiders is it's probably gonna be a longer game. So I wanna have this value.
Yeah, he hero power on turn 2, so it's yeah.
Shady, you've eventually become a noob in Raynette's eyes by saying thinning kappa. Isn't that the actual term in card games, thinning your deck? Oof. Yeah, I think we were right in picking the slower card in this particular game.
Oh.
I guess we are trading the 1-1 and then we play Croc, Glaive, use face to kill it off.
Yeah. I like that.
The other one is use on the hunting glaive. No, it's not as clean. Okay.
Yeah.
Trade the 1-1, play Croc first, then glaive. Ball of high mains.
I think as a warrior, we need like maximum our damage. Like,
yeah, that's
get the
a
most
good
value.
Yep.
And yeah, I agree with you. Ball of spider is better than the 3-drop.
Yep. Well, it's tough to see in that particular spot, but it's just the way, like, first of all, he's a 7-0 warrior, right? He's going to have some stuff. So I think it makes more sense to pick the slower card, try and get there. Speaking about slow, I'm gonna Wolf Rider's face.
Yeah, do we hero power or do we play the beard trap?
I like hero power. Face into the 2-2, Wolf Rider hero power.
The classic turn 5 play,
yeah.
The old school.
Turn 5 smart
face hunter.
Absolutely. Just curious, why didn't you guys decide to glaive before you popped the grandma? Because you don't want to power on the 1-1? Right? Or am I missing something?
Yeah, if the glaive lands on the grandma, that would be really bad.
Yeah, you overkill him. Alright, Spoders.
Yep.
Let's do it.
Reload.
There we go. Ball of high mains. Orking Crush. It's all good. I think thinning usually refers to altering the odds of draws, like mad scientists pulling secret ones. Tracking doesn't really do that. Does it not? Okay. If you thin your deck with tracking, you make it more likely that you draw cards that are reach, right? If you pull out 2 cards that aren't reach, you've now made it more likely you draw reach, right? Holy shit, that's a bad beast. Poor Pantry Spider.
We can Arcane Shot and get another one.
I think 1-1 into 3-3 is correct. Let's start with that, see what we hit.
Huh. That's actually not bad.
It's a really good pickup, yeah.
Yeah.
Mukla and then
Arcane Shot.
Yeah, Arcane Shot plus Mukla. Spin to win? Where's the times, guys? Spin to win. Play some Bladestorm Warrior in arena. Spin to win. Who here knows what I'm talking about? Okay. That's pretty solid.
Alright. Ooh.
Can you hear the background noise, by the way, guys? I guess for fun. What to do? So, if we banana to kill Don Han Cho, he's still gonna have one big ass motherfucker, but face isn't an option.
Yeah, I think we're not
So we
going to win
work
the
off
trading game.
7 mana. Could play this and this. Could buff here. I think one banana and kill Don Hancho is always happening.
Oh, so we are trading.
Yeah, you can't win the phase game, I think.
Sure.
Like, he's just going to play a big guy and kill us, right?
Okay.
It's kind of weird, but I think I just Nightblade, banana the Nightblade, and then play a Web Spinner.
Okay.
I play for board for a little bit. This makes Ghoul pretty darn good for him, of course.
Yeah, or any, like, Wardwing effect.
Wow, imagine if he buffed the Ghoul with Don Hancho. That's sick. Gets to play the big minion and AoE.
Don't worry, I'm gonna top deck Hunter's Mark.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay, that makes us think. Excellent, excellent. That's a
Whoa.
Great start. And we get a kitty. Yep.
Sure, I'll take that.
I think this it's very difficult to identify there that it's correct to go face. But it's a tough call.
Is he dead?
It's a lot of damage for sure. So Unleash is 2, 5, 7, 8, 13, 17. Are we one off?
One off, I think, if I count
Let's
it
do
right.
Do math again. What to do? Well, why don't we unleash and then trade a spinner into the 1-1 and see if we hit lethal with like Direwolf or whatever? Is Direwolf
nope.
even lethal? No.
Sure.
It's not that bad.
Tiger's good.
We know he's got one big guy and it could be a taunt, yeah. So if we on the hunt Tiger. Trade 3 1-1s, push 9 face, it's not bad. The 5 and the 4 definitely go face.
Yep.
We could also bow here. That's
I
probably
like Tiger wrong. And on the hunt.
Yeah,
I think.
Tiger on the hunt is fine. And I'm fine clearing.
Cleared it, right?
Yeah.
Also, we got Lethal next turn anyway.
Yeah, like he might. Oh, good that we didn't fuck that. Like.
Did I do anything wrong?
No, but I didn't realize that we might miss a dog if we don't kill something off, right? So. No one called lethal. I'm so proud of you guys. Well, it was a fairly, it was a lot of different damage sources. Sweet.
Yay!
Yeah, I honestly think if you smirk him on the Don Hancho turn, he gets insane trades and you could actually lose.
Right.
I'm not quite sure what I think of the meta right now, Valentino. Dear God, fourth priest!
Dude, Golden priest.
Stop! Stop with the priest egg.
Alright, only the weapon?
Yep, only the weapon. Dig hard for a 2 or a 1.
Scientist, go.
I'll take anything at this point. Shit. I should have not said anything. He's like, anything? Here's a sheep. A sheep is something. What class was the previous run? You're looking at it. Oh, man. Hopefully we draw. Hey, there we go.
Hey, let's go. Right.
So yeah, Potion of Madness here is fine. It's
yeah, he can't waste that one on this.
Yeah.
Just
it's okay.
So since we have a buff spider, are you considering the oh my god, the late game?
Oh, man, disgusting. Take that man out of here.
Glade trade.
How can you live with yourself? No, yeah, glade trade. Oh my god. Nasty. Nasty.
Even if you hit the other 1-1, it would be
yeah.
okay-ish.
You can on the hunt here, then, yeah.
Okay. Okay. On the hunt, Grandma.
Potion of Madness is really, really bad.
Yeah,
Like,
I know.
like disgustingly bad.
Are we afford to play around that, or are we just...
It, at some point you need to be like, your opponent is 8-0, so I don't think you can apply the same logic and say like, eh, I mean, if he has it, he has it. Like, he's very likely to have it. It's
right.
Also something you're probably keeping your mulligan against the hunter, because you know there's things like kind of grandma. Is it ever grandma pass? Makes it a bit less risky, right? I think it's either on the hunt and sheep or grandma pass, and I think I like grandma pass the most.
Okay. How about a villain? Ah, it's okay. Villain's okay.
Fine. I mean, it's just potion of madness that destroys you. So I think you just kind of grandma pass. Just
okay.
Go. Don't give him anything to break it on.
Sure.
That works out pretty well.
That's a okay multi-shot. Right?
Probably. Just taking the time to consider. You might want to pop the 1-1 regardless.
Hmm. Interesting.
Because it gives you more damage for next turn. So, one play is multi-shot. Tank it, deal one phase. The other play is trade multi-shot, take one phase, deal no phase, but you do have a 3-power minion. Next turn we probably glaive again.
What to do?
Play on the hunt, we should probably trade this in. On the hunt can't land on this, glaive can't land on this then. Two, four, five reach. I guess 5 reach is enough. Okay, let's keep the token alive. Multi-shot first, and phase the thing.
Okay. Yeah, it just, like a stealth brochure would be bad, but...
Yeah, there's also the 5 mana silence thing. Should probably play around that as well.
Oh,
I think
crap.
In the end, proccing is fine. Tough call, really tough call.
Hey, rewarded.
Yep. Ends up being rewarded, but tough call.
Still kind of awkward. The glaive is a clean trade.
You could prevent 6 phase here by using 1-1 go in. Wait, what am I looking
wait,
at?
What?
No. I'm looking at something else. Sorry. I didn't mean prevent 6 phase. I mean you can end up buffing the grandma. The 4-2 instead of the 2-1.
Right.
If you use on the hunt. That means you'd have a 4-2 and a 1-1 rather than a 3-2 and a 1-1.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, so trade the grandma first, then glaive, then tank it, then on the hunt, then hero power. It's very important in that order, otherwise he can potion of madness the 2-1 to kill your 3-2.
We got buff spiders. We got the reload. So.
Whew. I see Shady's in a good mood. Yeah, Drake. I fixed my shit. Oh. And then potion AoE. Oh.
Wait,
that
what?
That doesn't work. Oh, that does work, of course. Cause the
wait, did he
tentacle.
Just terribly fuck that up?
What well, should
he play
have
the
done?
Tentacle. Why are he playing the tentacle?
Because he can't
like
hit,
just...
right? He can't hit with the 1-1. If he potions with the pyro, then the pyro will kill the 1-1. So he needs the tentacle to deal the damage. But let's make him sad.
That's a lot of resource. That's a lot of resource.
Yep. Yeah, and we can just play a spinner now and be like,
yeah,
how about that pyro, my friend?
Alright, hold the weapon, right?
Yeah, hold the weapon.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is why Ball of Spiders is fine. It's for these matchups, right? The slow warrior, the slow priest. It's for those matchups that you really want to have one source of card draw, at least. Throw in a spider, see what we get. Not the worst thing. So... 2-2-1. Even if we play the beast, we still need to throw in one more, right?
Just to in case to say, he's holding the Druid's scrap card, 3-mana card.
Oh, okay, good catch,
and
good
it
catch.
Would
that could be a death. No, good catch. All right, let's throw in another 1/1. See if we get a good alternative then.
That's okay. So, could be useful.
So if you use Arcane Shot and Phase to kill it and play the beast, if he deads the beast, is that bad for us? I mean, obviously it is bad for us, but do we have another play?
I don't think so. I think this is the play.
Yeah, all right. So Arcane Shot and Phase to kill it, and then the beast. Yep. It's probably Shadow or Death. Good catch, by the way, with the Druid's Scarab card. I kind of forgot about that. But I mean, you got to play it at some point, and this is the easiest way for us to play it, I think.
Well, in case he doesn't have to death, then we...
Absolutely. Yeah, suddenly you have a decent position. Oh, sorry for that, guys. Aren't we being lucky? And then Shadow or Death?
That's the...
No. Okay.
Nope.
Turn this off. Oh, that's a pretty good hit. 1, 2, 2. So this is 4. So if the glaive lands on one of the hounds, that's pretty good.
What to do?
Mm-hmm. One goes in. No, actually, we don't even need the glaive to land on
one
of the hounds.
Look at just Wolf Rider, there's 3/3.
So you want a Wolf Rider to 3/3 and glaive. What if we hounds and glaive and we trade hound face, and then Wolf Rider his face?
Yeah, that's better. I mean, we'll just play the 3/3 plus the 2.
Yeah, all right, let's play Unleash the Hound.
Yep.
And no. Then, no, not yet. 1/1 into Chemist, 1/1 into Wolf Rider, then Wolf Rider, then Glaive, then face into that, and then face.
Nice. Rewarded, I think.
Yep.
We have 5, 6, 8. Doesn't heal, he dead. Rip. Alright, so draw a card, I mean, joust first, right?
Yeah, joust first. Glaive first, question mark. Why? Why glaive first? I don't think glaive first is correct, guys. Well, it's not great for us, but I guess the beast has to kill this guy. Yep.
We can double trade play Kodo.
Definitely Kodo. Definitely hero power. Mm-hmm. Definitely face into the 3/2. And now let's talk about this trade.
Alright, so if we don't trade, we're punished by Holy Nova.
We are also dead to Kraken if we don't trade.
Yeah,
if we go face, our opponent's at 10, he trades, we have 8. I think trade... Yeah, trade is correct, because Mind Control also kills us.
Yeah, we don't set up Liso.
Yeah, Mind Control also kills us.
Right.
Mind Control, Kraken, and Holy Nova are all big punishes. Well, so, Hunter's Mark. Kill Command. Nope.
That's the game.
Too much cheating. Ah, yep. So much cheating! Oh, I hate Priest! No, guys! We lost the game! Literally unplayable now. The run is over. Alright, let's take a moment. You should thank... Shady, you should thank. It was the chat. Without it, you wouldn't have picked Hunter. Chat knows better. Chat does indeed know. Keep it the glaive.
Yep.
Does she shower in a glass case? No, it's a regular plastic thing.
Hello, old friend.
Cool. Oh, you mean the clinging thing in the background? That's probably on Ocean's End.
Oh, hold on 1 second.
Anyone going like tick 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 tick? Is your girlfriend single? Smooth.
Yep.
Smooth.
Should be good now.
Alright.
Clay?
I think you're scientist. I don't think he trades.
Okay, sure.
People don't tend to trade against scientists, and then there's some upside next turn.
Right. Upside. Yep.
Sweet.
Alright, tracking first, right?
I agree. So, this means we're gonna pull bear trap. Maybe we should have pulled the trap first. No, that's fine. It's okay. So, glaive will clear the board. We're left with a glaive. Next turn, we have a 2-drop. If we pick mech warper, we have an easier time filling out our curve. If we pick power shot, we have more reactive capabilities.
Oh, we can do cat trick.
I don't think it's ever cat trick, right? He's burnt coined as well.
Yeah.
So scientist will kill this. We'll see what happens. Maybe push 3, maybe not.
I like power shot against the warlock. Yeah.
Yeah, I think power shot is correct.
All right.
And then you glaive, face into the frog first, and then maybe 3 face. I think if it lands on the scientist, you trade because of coil.
It lands on the face.
Yeah, I'd go face.
Go face?
Yep. Good play.
All right.
Huh. I mean, we're hunter, right? And we have power shot.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. It's not the worst thing. Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Okay, now we're pretty happy regardless, but otherwise it'd be pretty awkward. We could get more smork if you wanna. We could put face into the 2-1, equip a new glaive, play Murloc, and then push 4 with the bear.
I like that.
I like it as well. Okay. Phase a 2-1, equip glaive, push 4, play Murloc.
Yes, we
it's
are.
It's not likely, but thinking both secrets could be in the offer. Yes, yes. I think that's why trading with the scientist and then tracking was actually correct there. So girlfriend good at art, so no, she doesn't play. Ah. Did not break his spirit.
Power shot is pretty good.
I just want to make sure we don't automatically just play everything. So the alternative to power shot is face the 2-2 on the hunter guy, grandma hero power face. I don't think that's correct. Yeah. Okay. Power shot, kill the 2-2, the 2-1 ones.
Wait. Power shot the 2-2, 1-1, the 1-1, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yep. And absolutely. Then grandma.
Probably. You could also use on the hunt and then use save a weapon charge, but this is fine. Alright, yep. Face into the 1-1, face for 2.
Yep.
Shady is a Yasuo main? No, that's the irony. I was learning Yasuo at the time. Why not clear with a power shot and 1 mana card and still have a good port and push? So that's turn 4. Turn 4 we went with the other play pushes more face over the long run and sets up a better power shot.
Interesting.
So he can't abyssal us yet. I think therefore it's fine to use face into the 3-2, 1-1 into the 2-1 and Argent, or do we want to trade off the 2-1, play around the dread? No, this is fine. Yep. Grandma into the thing and then Argent face.
Time to go face. Positioning, I don't think it matters.
Yeah, I'd put the weakest guy in the middle because they can get cone from the courier.
Right. Wow, that was so quick. You think that's so quick?
Oh, no, that's just automated, right? It's right. Like the Cabal guys, they get cone. Mm-hmm. The Jade guys get Betrayal. The Goons get Explosive Shot. So against Goons, if there's nothing to play around Explosive and Power. And then, you know, Jade's is Betrayal and Cabal's is cone.
Okay.
I'm scared. What do we have? 5, 9, 10, 13. No lethal?
Is it? Two, five,
Three,
three.
four, six, 10, 15. Yeah, just make
Yeah.
sure you glaive before you on the hunt.
Yep.
Yep.
What to do?
GG.
Smork.
Perfecto, boys. Pew, 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 pew. Doesn't Cone deal one damage equally among the minions? You're right. But to play around Cone, if you only have three minions, you place the weakest minion in the middle. From that position, you can then separate your two strongest minions a lot easier when you play a fourth minion, and thus make it harder for him to Cone your two strongest minions. If you position your two strongest minions next to each other with three minions on the board, you actually can separate your two strongest threats the turn afterwards when you do go up to four minions. So it is a preventive positioning measure to put the smallest minion in middle versus Cone of Cold.
Rogue, okay.
Rogues, probably pretty good for us.
Yep.
Pretty great strategy. It's just something you pick up over like a long time of playing Arena, right? If you start to wonder, like, now, does it really not matter where I place something? You usually always find something where it matters, where you place your cards, so.
I'll only keep the two drop.
I agree, yep. Try to look for the early cards, the weapon, the minion. Keep the reactive cards for the mid game.
There we go.
Wave, there we go, baby! Mm.
Okay.
Everybody's got early game. I think you coined a croc. If he daggers and kills it, so be it. I think there's more upside if you croc and he plays a 2-drop.
Okay.
Yep. Not everybody daggers here and kills the croc. It's fine.
Yeah. It's just if he dagger, we're kind of awkward, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's absolutely awkward. But I think you can't assume that he daggers. Oh,
wow,
so
really?
Rewarded.
Are you serious? Okay.
I play a lot of Arena, man. It's just...
Wow.
Sometimes you feel where people can fuck up. Nice. Yeah. Yeah. I'd be very paranoid about Glaive if I were in this position, especially at 9-1, so I probably would have daggered, but... It's not automated for people to look at this. So lucky ShadyBunny gets a Glaive Zooka every time, right? It's almost like we've got four of them. It's amazing.
Scrap on turn three. Top deck a 3-drop. Go.
Oh, baby! Oh, let's do it, Ocean! Alright, I'm okay using phase to kill the 1-1 and push the 4.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't want to miss out on 4. I also don't want to leave anything for DID. Kabam! Look at that top deck game. Top deck game is on point here, chat. We got Hunter's Mark. Power if he spreads.
Interesting.
Sure. From what
Most
I can tell, it's either Alec Hero Power and then prep for the Power Shot next turn. That's
mm-hmm.
weak to Betrayal. He gets very nice Betrayal value. The other line, you can just KC this, go face. I don't really like that. So I think you go for the line that's weak to Betrayal and you place the King's Alec on the far right.
You're right. So in case we have a 2, probably not.
Yeah, just in general, this is better Betrayal
yeah.
positioning.
But
yeah.
We just smork, right?
Yeah,
and
we
hero
power and smork. And then next turn, if he plays a pit fighter here, it'd be pretty perfect because then you can Hunter's Mark, power shot, push phase
mm-hmm.
for 6. Okay.
Poison?
Yep.
Yep.
That's fine. He's taking damage. That's what we want.
Mm-hmm.
Mind if I roll knees?
Okay.
Still a decent power shot. So he's down to 10, and we have a KC in the hand. Ooh, probably better to develop. So power shot, definitely. Phase for 3,
yep.
definitely.
Yep. All right, comp damage time. Hero power set up. Oh no, he's gonna kill it.
Yeah, he's killing the beast. I think the mech warper's correct here.
Okay.
It, yeah, it provides a little bit more pressure right now.
Yeah, exactly. If he used the weapon to kill it, it's the same as hero power, right? And then he's still dead to DC. Also, I got a 1 mana sheep.
Yeah, this is a little tricky in case he has like SI, because then he can clear everything. Alright, so 2 off right now.
Divine Shield? That doesn't work. Alright, just put him at... no. Put him at... 5, so we can Kisei and Hero Power. I mean, go face and Hero Power always happen, right?
Yeah. I'm just trying to figure out if I want to Hunter's Mark his Worgen to prevent crazy lethals so he can't enrage it. I think that's correct.
Really? Okay.
Like, Cold Blood, enrage it, or what? Like, I'm just trying to find a way where we lose. So, face for 2 and Hero Power always happens, right?
Do we play the Cat Trick?
Yeah, I like Cat Trick and Hunter's Mark the Worgen.
Huh, okay, interesting. So no sheep, right? No.
No sheep, no.
Success to me, yeah.
Sheep makes it very awkward for the panther.
Yeah, we'll have a panther. Oh my god, I'm so stupid.
Also, if he has healing, you don't want him enraging the Worgen, right? Yeah, we just win. GG.
Yep.
Good stuff.
Face Hunter, man.
If he enrages the Worgen, that's 1 Wind Fury enrage condo. That's not true. He can shiv it, right? He can bomber it.
That's a snake trap.
He can Swashburglar on the hunt.
Oh my god, I'm playing this card.
Oh yeah, it's the swag lethal. They'll never know what... Good old Nightblade lethal. Pew!
Ten. One.
Hunter, man. Smork is back on the menu, boys. Let's go. Hey, more rogues. Feels good, man. More weapons. Feels good, man.
This is actually tricky, I think.
Absolutely. On the Hunt's very flexible, right? And it's very nice for turn 3 with a glaive. I'm pretty happy keeping On the Hunt and glaive.
So you never like tracking on turn 1, right?
No, I want to have more chance to land 2 drops, 1 drops, and have the tracking for the mid game.
Okay, sure.
I don't want to put myself in a position where I track and then I have to discard 2 reach cards to find a curve card in this start.
So just pass?
Yeah, just pass. Why do so many people think Hunter is one of the worst classes? It's super tough right now, Hunter Drake. I've definitely struggled. You're seeing all the good stuff now, right? But there's been a whole lot of bad stuff as well.
Is it the same guy? Wait, it's the same person.
Oh, okay. So what do we see of note? Poison. Loot Hoarder. No Loot Hoarder. Fiola or Adis, whichever one it was. Anything else of note? Strongwind Champions worth playing around. Worgen. Mm-hmm. So if you're scientist, he trades. He's got coin. If he gets On the Hunt, it's pretty... If he gets Catrick, it's pretty good.
Yeah, also he might just Hero Power and hit face. We got a Bear Trap too.
Yeah, I think Mad Scientist is fine.
Okay.
It's 3 p.m. It's still only your second run. Are you going to do another run later? Yeah, absolutely. No.
He just... Okay. So he's playing around Bear Trap.
Fiola was from Scarab. Good one. Okay. On the Hunt glaives, playable.
Yep.
On the Hunt this guy, equip the glaive. Pass.
And just pass.
Yep. It was Scarab and he had a loot. Okie dokie. You just say milling is bad, discarding from tracking is picking the 3 cards from the 3 cards you milled. No, I mean, I don't want to do it early on. I want to do it later in the game.
Oh boy.
So we hero power.
Yep, and then just use the face to kill that thing. Or, nah.
Yeah, hero power and face, it's fine. Use face to kill this guy. So he has a fantastic turn 3, followed by our fantastic turn 4. We got Nightblade, boys. These draws? Yeah, well, I mean, we're ready to go, right? What's this? 3, 6, 8, 10, 12. We got 12 damage right now. So 6 more hero powers and we're there. Let's do it.
Oh man, I was about to say save the weapon for the power shock, and then we actually have the power shock. Anyway,
I think it's probably just Arcane Shot and face to kill this guy, and then hero power pass, right? Or do you want to power shot it next turn and let it connect here? Who to shoot? I'm inclined to clear it, just to play around buffs, just to play around him.
Yeah, this thing can get buffed, right? So, yeah. I guess.
I think Arcane Shot kill it and hero power is fine. I don't think you ever play Nightblade here because you miss out on damage. Plus, if he eviscerates, you just delete your Nightblade.
Yeah. Boy, oh, we do have a cat though, but.
Sorry? Let's... Yeah, we have a cat drake. It's true. It's cat. True. Evis is not. But once again, if we can make it even more annoying for him, I think it's better. There's our boy Worgen.
Oh boy.
Okay. History repeats itself. I think here we don't have much choice. It's just Nightblade pass.
What he can play on turn 6? What's the...
You mean something rogue specific, or do you mean something that makes it awkward for us?
I don't know what he played last game, but I know turn 7 it could be Stormwing, right?
Yep. Yeah, that's why I think we Nightblade now, and if he ignores, then we Hunter's Mark Power Shot clear the board.
Gotcha.
If he kills it, then he takes 4 damage. It's fine.
All right, Nightblade.
Yeah, and if he uses a spell, we get Catrick, that's all good. I know I'd rather save Nightblade for when I can Nightblade plus hero power, but the alternative to Nightblade is like kill command his minion, which is just as bad as missing damage here, so.
Interesting. Good play.
Stormwind's not a turn 6 play, guys.
Okay, that's pretty good.
So next turn, Stormwind.
Yeah.
We could Hunter's Mark, Power Shot, Arcane Shot this turn, and then just Hero Power face. That's 6 damage. He's down to 13. Kill Command, Hero Power is 5, 9. He's down to 4. Could also develop the Mech Warper.
I don't like Web Worker because he got the 3-2 weapon, right? It's the same thing, I think.
Alright, let's Hunter's Mark the Squid Face, Arcane Shot the Worgen, Power Shots, Hero Power, Smork. I think it's fine, you just keep clearing his boards. Don't give him an option to be aggressive.
Right. He doesn't have any heal, right, from last game?
We didn't see any healing coming out.
Yeah,
from
we didn't
him,
see any, yeah.
So I think, yeah, you're throwing away a ton of resources that could go face. I feel like it makes more sense to clear his board, especially knowing he has Stormwind Champion in his deck. Because if he doesn't have a board to pressure you, then you win anyway. That's kind of the thought process there. If this 4-4 gets to keep dealing damage, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
He's got to know it's Catrick, though. Yeah, he should have a fairly good idea that it's Catrick. Which is probably why we haven't seen a spell yet. Thank you. Might have to do it now. Don't worry,
loves. The cavalry's here. Okay. Is he gonna take the damage?
No. He pushes face here. So.
Alright. Hey, that's okay, see?
2 damage off.
He is 3 damage off. Stormwing is 1 off.
So What if we grub kill commander's minion and then hero power face? That pushes six and you have the board. He's got a coin, but you have a cat trick.
I think the 4-4 goes face.
Yeah, 4-4 definitely goes face. I'm pretty happy we grub kill commander's 5-4. Because if he uses spells to remove, you get more damage anyway.
Yeah, yeah, if he uses spell, yeah. Forgot the cat trick. Yeah, I think it's...
So let's kill command the 5-4 and then talk about the mech warper. I think hero power is better. Just get the guaranteed damage in.
So this... Yeah.
Yeah, it's in case he plays taunt, right? Then you have higher chance to just kill him. Warfreak, thank you so much for the sub. Good to see you. Welcome back. Okay.
Sure. Well, he's so afraid of a spell. That's actually a good cat trick. Cat trick is always good against rogue.
Yep.
Smork?
Your opponent seems to be very happy racing you. I assume he has some reach in his hand. I don't think he's happy racing us. I think he just realizes that if he trades, there's zero chance to win, right? He's at 10 wins. He probably knows how to play this game, right?
Glazuka is lethal. And we have
we need 3 damage. Eagle Horn will do. Oh, that's as good as lethal, right? Yep.
Yeah.
Multi hero power develop the thing. Pew pew pew. Yeah.
We're gonna be rich.
No. No being rich in this stream. No. Playing Rogue v Hunter and Hunter v Rogue is a very delicate game. It's because the Hunter has more sustained damage, but the Rogue suddenly goes. Surprise, motherfucker! Super damage.
Oh.
Oh. Don't do it, bro. Nah, it's just showing. GG.
I was like, coin deathwing. No.
GG.
Beat this guy twice.
Alright, guys. Let's do some more digging. Let's do it. I was waiting for coin deathwing. Oh, God. Please don't. Well, if we coin Deathwings, there's still a decent chance we win, because we need one damage. Back to back Hunter Diggies, holy shit!
Is that the same? No, it's not the same person.
But it is a rogue, and we like rogue! That's a pretty good hand! Holy shit! Just the Glaivezuka for me, please.
Never Ketrick, right?
No. We have a scientist. I don't keep secrets if I have scientists. I mean, can't ask for much more. Look at that. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. We got options. Buccaneer? He thought about playing something.
Mm. Yeah. I see that too.
Oh my god.
Oh,
so,
crap.
I'm not saying we do it, but if we go Murloc and Beast, we can buff everything with Zubat. I think the correct play here is probably Mech Warper Pass and an extra Glaive. I think that's correct.
Yep. Another consideration is Grandma. If he plays a 3-2, we can buff, but...
If he plays a 3-2, you can glaive it down, right?
Oh, wait, this is a mech.
Yeah. That is a mech.
Alright.
A pretty good card.
Eh, not too good here, though. Just tied to the 3-1.
So our opponent plays a 3-drop next turn. If we play King's Elec, he probably trades the Warper or the Elec. Probably the Elec and then plays a thing. I think we'd rather play Grandma and push Two-Face.
Yeah, because we can buff with the Zubat.
Yeah, we can buff it with the Zubat or we can buff it with Glaivezuka. So we can deal with a lot of stuff. We're probably buffing it with Glaivezuka. Mm-hmm. Glaivezuka allows us to kill a 3-4 or a 4-3, depending on whether we trade first or buff first. This is back-to-back digging with Hunter. Holy shit, dude. Love it. Love it! Annoyatron, the bane of my existence! Alright. Let's make sure we get this one right. So we could Zubat and knock the shield off. That means we'd have a 2-1 and a 3-3 versus a 1-2. It's pretty good. We could knock the shield off and then buff. That means we'd have a 3-4 and a 3-3.
With a 4-3, right?
A 4-3, yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
I meant, yeah. Just ignore that. Huh.
I actually like keeping the death rattle. Huh.
Yeah, the only problem is that he uses the 2-3 to free kill. But then you can put the 3 in, glaive here. We can dagger down to 2-1 and then trade here. Do we care? No, we can trade anyway. Yeah, I'm okay with Zubat and then bump the bubble.
Alright, Zubat first.
Yep, yep, yep.
Nice.
I got that Yu-Gi-Oh! Reference, Shady. Oh man. If we ever get new emotes, we need one looking like a mining pick. Oh, I mean, we got the shady diggies, right? I don't think we need two emotes dedicated to digging. We're mining the rogue's face for gold, guys. We're mining our opponent for resources here. Wait, why not buff after the trade? Because this keeps your first charge alive, which then makes it more awkward for him. You have the Glaive Zuka next turn to go back into the 2-1. If you proc and then buff, he can still kill it off. I feel like you give him more trouble with buffing first.
Why not play this first? Huh. Whatever. Oof. I think we glaive first.
Yeah, I think we glaive first and then Alec. And we're probably just pushing for. Let him trade stuff.
You don't like the Murlocs? Just die for free, right?
I don't like the Murlocs.
Also, it could draw something huge.
Yep. Get a 5, get a 6.
That's good.
Beautiful.
Alright, so 4 face.
Yeah, 4 face. Can't see me dick face anyways. Can't see minions, me no trade. Skulker, that'd be pretty bad for us.
So he does have a panda. I mean, I don't know. It's like a car.
Yep.
Shadow Pan Rider.
It's got a panda. He does have a panda.
DID. You good?
Yep. Takes the damage. This might be sheep hero power, but we'll see how we draw first.
We can kill it with on the hunt plus bow. Is that too much?
Alternatively, we can go really aggressive, just go phase hero power and then equip Eagle Horn.
Okay.
Just throwing it out there, right? So if we follow that line, our opponent goes to 15, we've got 7 next turn, that's still a little bit away.
Right.
If we go phase for 2 and then Murlocs plus Eagle Horn, what does that do?
I'm not a huge fan, but could be.
I don't hate sheep hero power here, honestly.
So what do we do next turn?
We use our face to clean that up and then we Argent, or we use our face to clean it up and then play Murlocs and other stuff. I actually like the sheep hero power. Yep. It makes use of a resource that usually isn't that great.
Do we pre-hit?
No. No, I don't think we do.
He's just gonna use the weapon and we're gonna miss the damage.
Pre-hitting's not terrible here, but I don't think it matters too much.
Right.
Because you're probably playing Argent anyway.
Yep.
And if he trades with the dwarf, you can actually on the hunted. So, okay, chooses to take one extra phase to deal four phase and use two mana. It's not the worst.
Yeah. That's a shade.
Shady on curve. So if we go with the Argent play here, our opponent's at 12, we are at 20. Next turn we can start a Weaving Hero Powers. I like that. Mm-hmm. I like Argent. Yep. Face into the 4-2, push 4.
Yep. This card is good. Yep. Even if it's Morgs, it's good. Just do a 4-2.
Yeah, I think that using the sheep there is really using, you know, using a resource that usually isn't that great. Okay, that's fine. Most of his, that's probably the best answer to that, but that's fine.
He's attacking, huh? Interesting.
Yeah, I would attack in his position.
Okay.
He's got to pressure us.
Absolutely. Oh, hello, friend.
So, we could deal five face now, which would put him at 7. And the next turn, probably kill him. We could also Ego Hombo on the Shade if we're afraid.
He have a random beast. Doesn't really matter.
If we end up bowing the Shade, what happens? We're at 13. Play a thing. He plays cards. He could potentially threaten lethal. If we go face, he goes to 9, 7. This is 5 already. You have hounds. You have
I think we go face, honestly.
I think so too. I think it's bow, scientist, hero power, face for 5.
Yep. Yeah. So we still have the double traps.
Yeah, there's double traps. You've got hounds and on the hunt to help you out.
Yeah, it's just the unleashed hunt in hand makes me not want to trade. So we get one extra doggy off course.
I think you get in more trouble if you trade here, guys. If you use your weapon to trade, you're not threatening lethal. If you're not threatening lethal, your opponent can just play any big minion and suddenly you know you're probably dying the turn after. Sure.
Star. So that's the from the web spinner, right? Yeah. All right, that's the game.
Yep.
He's gonna re-dagger. Boom. Back to all.
Bow the Shade playing the 2/2s is only bad to Skulker. But you don't need to Ochre. This just pushes the damage and kills him, right?
Holy, this deck.
Oh, 24 like... and 1. Not bad.
All right. Let me...
Feels good, man.
Here. That's like exactly two different hunter archetypes. So yep. One control yep. Midranger, that one smork.
One is burn face oriented, the other one midrange. Yep.
Alright, you
see what's in there. Yep, we're good, man.
Alright.
So guys, who predicted 12? Let's have a look.
That's okay. I got a golden card.
Yeah, not quite as ridiculous as the other rewards, but those were pretty nasty.
Nope.
He'd be at 10 if you trade. Yeah, but you just make it much less likely, right? One small town for its time.